Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on engine misfires and how to properly diagnose and repair issues that cause misfires. Before moving into all of the specific details of this video, it's important to cover misfires in a very general sense. What is actually a misfire and what causes engine misfires? Basically, a misfire means that something in the combustion process went wrong and led to either no combustion or just partial combustion. So essentially, this could be caused by any sort of air-fuel mixture issues or a lack of a spark or ignition to actually ignite that air-to-fuel mixture. So there are a lot of different causes and things that can actually lead to engine misfires and things that we'll be discussing throughout most of this video. But before we move on to that part of the video, it is important to mention one thing. Modern PCMs, ECUs, DMEs, different manufacturers refer to them as different things, but ultimately modern car computers are very capable at identifying misfires and storing that information in the computer, basically, which can be read by an OBD2 scanner. So if you are having engine misfires and you're looking to diagnose these issues, that certainly is a very valuable and important tool to have in the process. So make sure you have some sort of OBD2 code scanner or reader to help identify any issues that may be causing engine misfires. With engine misfires, a couple common symptoms that you will notice: check engine light and generally a stored code in the PCM or ECU. So have that OBD2 scanner to go ahead and read the codes. That can help identify what cylinder is misfiring. Something like a P0300 code is just a general misfire code. However, you may get more specific codes like P0301, which means cylinder one misfire, P0302, which is cylinder two misfire, and so on and so forth. So having that handy and being able to identify exactly which cylinder is misfiring is certainly helpful. And again, you'll generally get a check engine light or a service engine soon light with a misfire. A lot of cars also flash the check engine light if you do have a misfire, so it might flash two or three times quickly. If it's just one misfire, you might not even notice that, but generally that will trigger the engine light to stay on for a given time frame and possibly for a while if the engine does keep misfiring consistently. Some common symptoms of misfires are a rough idle as well as stuttering, hesitation, and just sluggish feeling acceleration. And then you might also notice a change in engine sound. Basically, when a misfire occurs, again, it's either partial combustion or no combustion, so that certainly can change the sounds and noises coming from your engine. So if you notice something along that degree, it could very well be an engine misfire. Moving into some of the most common causes of misfires, number one, there's the ignition system. This is one of the biggest things that ties into partial or no combustion. Of course, once you have that air-fuel mixture in the cylinder, in the combustion chamber, it then has to be ignited, and that process is done through the ignition coils and the spark plugs, both of which are standard maintenance items. On most cars, the spark plugs will have to be replaced roughly every 30,000 to 80,000 miles, whereas ignition coils are about double that and tend to last about 60,000 to 150,000 miles. But standard maintenance items are wear and tear items, and so certainly among the most common causes for engine misfires, especially if you haven't kept up with that maintenance and you know that your spark plugs and or ignition coils are past due for service. Number two is issues with the actual air to fuel mixture itself. So if you have too much air, too little air, too much fuel, not enough fuel, any issues with the air fuel mixture can cause misfires, because of course, if you don't have enough of one part air or fuel, then that's going to lead to an incomplete burn or potentially even no combustion at all, depending on how bad the lack of air or fuel flow or how much extra there is. So a couple of the most common things to look out for here when it comes to air fuel mixture issues, it's a pretty long list of what can actually cause this. Anything from a vacuum leak to actual fueling system issues like a leaking fuel injector or a stuck fuel injector that's not flowing any fuel or limited fuel, issues with the fuel pump, so high pressure fuel pump or a low pressure fuel pump. If they're not delivering enough fuel, then that can lead to issues. And then even simple things like a clogged air filter can limit airflow enough to lead to misfires. And same thing with the fueling system, a clogged fuel filter can cause issues and engine misfires. So that's still not quite an exhaustive list, but certainly a few of the most common things to look out for when you do have air fuel mixture issues. Check for any vacuum leaks, check for any fueling system issues, which are all fairly common causes of engine misfires. Moving on to the next common cause of engine misfires, we have sensors, modules, and electrical issues. So again, this is a pretty lengthy list that can include a lot of different components, but ultimately it's not just the air fuel mixture and the actual ignition itself. Modern cars use many different sensors, modules, and electrical components to ensure that the car has the proper amount of air and fuel being delivered into the engine, and also timing the ignition or the spark to ignite that air fuel mixture. So any issue with the sensor related to that can certainly cause engine misfires. And so some of the common ones there, problems with O2 or oxygen sensors, the mass airflow sensor or MAF or MAF sensor for short, as well as manifold absolute pressure or MAP sensors. Those are a few common sensors that can lead to engine misfires. And then you also have wiring and electrical things like the ignition wiring harness, which somewhat ties into the ignition system. But if you do have those electrical issues, like with the ignition wiring harness, then that can cause problems with getting the proper voltage to the ignition coil to actually ignite or spark the spark plug. Last but not least on the list, number four here, we have mechanical engine problems. And this is certainly the least common out of all the ones that we're discussing. Basically, mechanical engine problems tie down to low compression. So essentially the cylinder or combustion chamber has to be airtight and seal up very neatly and very closely so that you can have proper compression for the air fuel mixture, ignition, and combustion. When you don't have proper compression, of course, air and fuel can seep out of any little open areas, and that can cause engine misfire. So a couple common things there are anything from cylinder wall scoring to issues with the piston rings to valve train problems like valve stems, actual exhaust valve or intake valve problems, worn out cam lobe, tons of different things that could be mechanical engine problems that lead to engine misfires and ultimately a lack of compression. This is one of the least common things, especially on newer vehicles. However, it's certainly a possibility, especially on engines or cars that are getting up to 150,000, 200,000 plus miles. Naturally, things wear down over time and the engine internals are going to start getting a little bit tired and could potentially lead to low compression and eventually low enough compression to the point that you have significant power loss and engine misfires and a whole host of other problems. Now, essentially, this is very tough to diagnose. In most cases, it'll require actually opening up the engine and taking a closer look internally, or at least borescoping the engine to see if there's anything visible or noticeable from that extent. But sometimes it can lead to a need to actually open up the engine and take a look inside and see what exactly went wrong mechanically to cause low compression. But ultimately, best way to test for that is just a compression test. Fairly simple way to check and make sure that all of your cylinders have proper compression. If that is the case, then you can totally eliminate this from the list of things that could be causing your misfires. But again, something to definitely be on the lookout for if you have an older car with higher mileage where the engine might just be getting a little bit tired and could potentially be on its last leg. Moving into diagnosing engine misfires, the number one thing to start with is using an OBD2 scanner or similar software device to scan for any stored engine codes. So this will give you a good idea as to, number one, what cylinders specifically are misfiring, whether it be one cylinder, two cylinders, or all six or eight or 10 or whatever engine size you have, can help narrow down and give you a specific cylinder to start looking for and figuring out where those issues are. And additionally, reading the codes can help point you in the right direction in terms of a lot of the times if you have an issue with, say, something like a mass airflow sensor or an oxygen sensor, a fuel pump problem like a low pressure fuel pump, you'll typically have more codes stored in the PCM or ECU that can point you in the right direction. You might see codes indicating that that oxygen sensor or one of the oxygen sensors on the engine is having issues, or that the fuel pump is having issues. Again, a whole host of things that can point you in the right direction. But a lot of these problems will have additional codes that are stored outside of just an engine misfire. So that's definitely the best point to start. And if you do get a code, go down that route. If you get a code for an oxygen sensor, of course, that's going to be your best starting point or your best next step in the process is actually checking and potentially replacing that oxygen sensor. If you don't have any other codes though, and you just have the engine misfires, then it might take a little more time and effort and diagnostic to point you in the right direction. But before moving into anything else, start with the basics, check the engine bay, look for any obviously loose, cracked, damaged, missing pipes, connections, vacuum lines, check the air filter, make sure that your airbox doesn't have a bunch of leaves and dirt and debris that could be blocking airflow. Tons of different things. Take a quick look at the simple things that don't take much more than 20 or 30 minutes in the driveway just to make sure that nothing is obviously out of place that could be causing the engine misfires or any other issues. If everything checks out there, then for step three, generally a good idea if you just have misfires and no other engine codes is replacing the spark plugs and or ignition coils. This is especially true if you know that you're past the typical maintenance interval for those parts. Definitely a good thing to get replaced anyway, even if that's not the root cause of the problems. However, if you know that you're up to date on that maintenance, you have newer spark plugs and newer ignition coils, you can still test these very easily. Once you know what cylinder is misfiring, you can simply take the ignition coil, let's say cylinder one is misfiring, for example, take the ignition coil from cylinder number one and move it to another random cylinder that isn't misfiring, let's just say cylinder four. Once you move that ignition coil from cylinder one to four, take the car out for a drive and rescan for codes. If the engine misfire has now moved to cylinder number four, you know that the ignition coil is the root cause of that engine misfire. And same thing goes for spark plugs if it isn't the ignition coil. So you swapped them out and that misfire still stays on cylinder number one. Now you can take that spark plug from the first cylinder and move it to say cylinder three. And double check again, if that misfire moves to the new cylinder, then you found your issue in that spark plug. If the spark plug's ignition coils, which again are one of the most common causes, aren't the actual root problem that is leading to misfires, then it's time to move on to additional testing, compression testing, as we had mentioned, for checking for any potential mechanical issues and low cylinder compression, and a whole host of other testing that you can do, such as testing voltage to different sensors and modules and things of that nature. So certainly gets a little more in-depth if you make it to that step. But again, most of the time with an engine misfire, simply scanning for codes, either it's just a misfire and it's likely the spark plugs and ignition coils, or one of the two, or you get another code associated with the misfire that helps point you in the right direction, like an oxygen sensor or something along those lines. That wraps up our video today. If you guys appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks, guys.